Have you ever wished you could go back in time and change something in your past? Or pay one last visit to someone special? Or maybe visit the future and see what it holds for you? Time travel is one of the most fascinating concepts in science fiction, but could it actually be possible? And if so, what are the consequences and paradoxes of altering the past or future? Time travel is a hypothetical movement of a person or object across different points in time. There are two main types. Forward and backward time travel. Forward time travel is when someone travels to a later point in time, or the future. This type of time travel is actually possible according to Einstein's theory of relativity, which states that time passes at different rates depending on the speed and gravity of an observer. If you were to travel on a spaceship near the speed of light, or near a very massive object like a black hole, time would pass slower for you than it would for someone who is standing on Earth. This means that when you return to Earth, less time would have passed for you, and you would effectively have traveled to the future. Backward time travel is much more problematic and controversial, as it violates one of the most fundamental principles of physics, causality. Causality is the idea that every effect has a cause that precedes it in time. For example, if you break a glass, the cause is your action of dropping it, and the effect is the glass shattering. But if you could travel back in time and prevent yourself from dropping the glass, then what would be the cause of the glass shattering? This leads to a number of paradoxes and inconsistencies that challenge our understanding of logic and reality. There are two main categories of time travel paradoxes: consistency paradoxes and causal loops. Consistency paradoxes occur when changing the past creates an inconsistency with the original timeline. A famous example is the grandfather paradox, which asks, what would happen if you traveled back in time and killed your own grandfather before he met your grandmother? If you did that, then you would have never been born, which means you couldn't have traveled back in time to kill your own grandfather in the first place. Another example of a consistency paradox is Polchinski's paradox, which involves a billiard ball traveling through a wormhole to the past and hitting its past self in such a way that it prevents itself from ever entering the wormhole. One possible way to resolve consistency paradoxes is to assume that there are multiple parallel timelines or universes that branch off every time someone changes the past. This way, there is no contradiction between what happened and what didn't happen, because they happened in different realities. For example, if you killed your grandfather in one timeline, you would still exist in a different timeline, where you didn't kill him. Causal loops occur when changing the past creates a self-consistent loop of events that have no origin or end. A common example of this paradox is the bootstrap paradox, which asks, what would happen if you traveled back in time and gave yourself an object or information that you didn't have before? For example, if you traveled back in time and gave yourself a book that you later used to write your own book, then where did the book come from? You didn't create it, but neither did anyone else. It seems to exist without any cause or origin. A different example is a predestination paradox, which occurs when changing the past causes an event that was already a part of history. For example, if you traveled back in time and tried to stop a murder from happening, but you actually ended up being the murderer yourself, then you would have caused the event you tried to prevent. This creates a loop of events that are self-consistent, but also inexplicable. One possible way to resolve causal loops is to assume that they're inevitable and predetermined, and that any attempt to change the past will only result in fulfilling one's role in the loop. This is known as the Novikov self-consistency principle, which states that any action taken by a time traveler is already part of history and can create a paradox. Despite the paradoxes and problems associated with time travel to the past, some scientists have proposed ways to test if it's possible or not. One of the most famous proposals is the idea of sending a message or a signal to the past using a tachyon. A tachyon is a hypothetical particle that travels faster than light, and therefore can travel backwards in time according to relativity. If we could send a tachyon signal to the past, we could communicate with our past selves. A different proposal is the idea of creating a wormhole that connects two points in space and time and using it as a time machine. A wormhole is a hypothetical tunnel in space-time that can allow travel between distant locations or times. If we could create a wormhole that connects the present with the past, we could travel through it and visit our own history. This could hypothetically be done by moving one end of a wormhole near a very massive object or accelerating it to a very high speed. This would then cause time dilation, which means that time would pass slower for that end of the wormhole than for the other end. This would create a difference in time between the two ends of the wormhole, allowing us to travel from one end to the other and end up in a different time. If we then moved both of these wormholes next to each other, we would have a working time machine. However, creating and maintaining a wormhole would require exotic forms of matter and energy that may not exist or be accessible. Time travel may be an exciting and captivating idea, but it might also be an impossible and dangerous one. Perhaps it's better to leave time travel to the realm of fiction and focus on living in the present and shaping our future. After all, Albert Einstein once said, "The distinction between past, present, and future is only a stubbornly persistent illusion."